Hi folks, John Zajaros here. Well, this is your first stop if you decide to start into an internet inbound marketing consultancy. The Chamber of Commerce. There's a wealth of information. I'll go over it when I get back to the office, but this is your first stop. Hi folks, John Zajaros here with UltimateInternetImage.com, and today I want to talk to you about setting up your internet inbound marketing consultancy. Now, the very first step that you, once you've decided that this is what you want to do, and you know, I'm not one of these people that is in it for the short haul, that is in it to make a few bucks and get out. If that's what you're in it for, then you want to find something else to do, because you're going to be dealing with people on a long-term basis. You're going to be making a commitment to them. You should care about their success, and you should have a great deal of empathy, meaning you need to know what motivates people, and what motivates people is making it in business, is making it in these tough times. So if you're involved or you're thinking about becoming involved in an internet inbound marketing consultancy for the short-term gain, forget about it. Click off right now, go back, go to somebody else's site, because this is not going to be for you. Now, the very first step that you need to take, as I said, once you decide that this is what you want to do, is you need to go to your Chamber of Commerce, and you need to decide whether you're going to join the Chamber or not, and frankly, it's a good idea. But in addition to that, you need to decide that you're going to make certain contacts in the city. You're going to introduce yourself to the appropriate people at City Hall. You're going to take care of any licenses that you need to do. And then you're going to join the Chamber of Commerce. Now, generally when you join the Chamber of Commerce, you'll get a membership packet, something like this. And in the membership packet, they'll give you marketing opportunities, different things that you could become involved with that will give your business some exposure. It will also give your business some credibility, provided you become active and provided that you conduct yourself properly. Just during the stop, I also was able to or was given by the CEO of the chamber a real nice resource, the Ohio Small Business Development Center, and they have templates and different things for the various steps that you need to go through, the legalese, all of the paperwork and the managerial stuff, and probably the stuff, if you're anything like me and you're almost 100% entrepreneur, it's not going to be your forte, and this is something that you really need to take a look at. Now, you probably have one of these regardless of where you are in the United States. It'll probably be something similar. Because as the young lady who helped me said at the chamber, why reinvent the wheel? So I'm certain that this has been copied many times over, and it's a good idea to investigate that. And then you get the chamber news, and you get different things like that. In addition to all of that, probably the thing that's worth its weight in gold, and the thing that I've talked about previously, is the Chamber magazine. And in the Chamber magazine, if you go to the back, and if it's not in the magazine, then generally the Chamber will have a specific directory of members. But in this case, the directory is in the back of the magazine. And it includes the name of the contact people and all the rest of that. And that's really helpful. Now, in addition to all of that, you're going to get probably a calendar. And I want you to take a look at the calendar, because if you notice something right away, then you're a marketer. If you don't, then you probably should be doing something else. But look at all around this calendar. Need I say more? You know, it's an unbelievable resource for at least people to talk to. Now, I'm not talking about spamming, and I'm not talking about joining the chamber just so you can get a hold of the lists. Because again, if that's what you're after, then you got to be doing something else, because you will get blackballed real fast, believe me. But if you're in this for the long haul, and if you're sincere, and if you're qualified, and if you put your clients first, people will pick up on that and you will be accepted. I've done this several times in different businesses over the years, and the Chamber can be an absolutely fantastic resource. Darlene Watkins in Vermilion was just invaluable when I was starting my business 30 years ago, my first business. But again, you'll also get a map, and this is the Lakewood City map, and once again, take a look at what we've got here. Not only do you have the layout of the city, which is nice because then as you start to call on different people, you can actually put one of these up on the wall and put little tags in there so that you're covering certain areas if that's going to be your focus instead of the business sectors. So that's basically it. That gets you started. Now, once you get started, we're going to get into carding, and carding will be the next step in the process, and I will explain that as we go. But for right now, your first step should be to visit City Hall and to join the Chamber of Commerce, or at least make the first introduction, the first contact at the Chamber. Frankly, the lady didn't even take me back in her office today. I probably would have signed up right on the spot, paid her the money, did whatever I had to do. But, that's sometimes the difference between administrators and marketers. I would have done things a little bit differently, but she was very nice, very cordial, very helpful. Just wasn't made to feel 100% at home, and that kind of surprised me. But again, you've got to take things as they come because not everyone is going to do things as you would do them. And so you've got to be flexible. You've got to put your best foot forward. And once again, you are going to be representing yourself in a business, in a community, or in communities. And therefore, you need to put your best foot forward and your best face forward. So that's lesson number one. Best of luck to you. If you've started with the Traffic Geyser program, then you already know what you've got in front of you because it's going to be a fantastic ride. If you didn't take that step, you can still join Traffic Geyser, and that is an invaluable resource. I will go over some other resources that I feel that you might need, but we'll talk about that as time goes on. Thanks, folks. Take care. Best of luck to you. Bye-bye.